अस्सलाम वालेकुम क्लास थ्री, हाउ आर यू? आई एम योर टीचर मिस माहीन एंड इट इज योर इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज क्लास. ओके, सो क्लास थ्री, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अवर न्यू चैप्टर, यूनिट नंबर 18, एंड द चैप्टर नेम इज द विजर्ड ऑफ ओज. ओके, दिस इज अवर न्यू चैप्टर. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट दिस चैप्टर फ्रॉम लेसन नंबर 3, रीडिंग द विजर्ड ऑफ ओज. ओके, नाउ I am going to read the story and I want you to listen the story very carefully and repeat every sentence after me and put your finger according to the sentences. Okay, now I am starting it. Listen very carefully. Okay, the instructions are read the story and answer these questions. Okay, first we are going to read the story and then we will answer the questions according to the story. Okay, where was Dorothy's house at the start of the story? Where was it at the end? Okay, now this story is about a girl named Dorothy and we want to know that where was her house at the start of the story and where was it at the end. Okay, this story is something about Dorothy's house. Okay, now I am starting it. Dorothy lived in a small town house in Kansas with Uncle Henry, Aunt Em, and a little black dog called Toto. Okay, so Dorothy is a girl. She lived in a small town house in Kansas. Okay, where she lived? She lived in Kansas with her Uncle Henry, Aunt Em, and she had a little black dog called Toto. It was often very windy in Kansas. Okay, sometimes the wind came very fast and very suddenly. That was a cyclone and it could blow trees, people and buildings away. Okay, what is a cyclone? When the wind was blowing very fast, that it can blow the trees, the houses or the buildings, that is called a cyclone. Okay, so in Kansas the weather was like this. There were cellars under all the houses. So in Kansas there is the danger of cyclone, so the people of Kansas always built a house under their houses. They built a room under their houses under the ground. And that room is called cellar. Okay, what the cellars are? Cellars are the rooms that are made under the ground to save themselves from these types of cyclones. Okay, if the cyclone hit and their house become destroyed, then they will become safe because of these cellars. Because whenever a cyclone comes, they went down into the cellar under the ground so that all the things happened over the ground and nothing can get harmed under the ground. Okay, so that is why they made cellars. And when a cyclone came, people went down into their cellars and stayed there until the cyclone had passed. Okay, so just I have mentioned all the things about cellars. One day Uncle Henry looked up at the sky and ran back quickly into the house. "There's a cyclone coming," he told Aunt Em and Dorothy. "We must go down into the cellar." So what is happening? One day a cyclone was coming, so Uncle Henry ran towards the house and he told Aunt Em and Dorothy that we must go to the cellar because the cyclone was coming. They ran to the door of the cellar, but Toto was afraid and hid under the bed. Dorothy ran after him. What happened? They ran towards the cellar, but Toto was not there. Where was Toto? Toto was very afraid and he hid himself under the bed on the ground. So Dorothy ran after him to pick the Toto. "Quick," shouted Aunt Em from the cellar. "Leave the dog and came down here into the cellar." Aunt Em and Uncle Henry was in the cellar and they were shouting to the Dorothy that quick, just leave the dog and come towards the cellar. But Dorothy didn't listen and she go टू पिक द डॉग. डोरोथी पिक्ड अप टोटो एंड रन टू द सेलर डोर. जस्ट वंस शी पिक्ड द टोटो शी रन टुवर्ड्स द सेलर रूम. बट व्हाट हैपेंड, बट बिफोर शी रीच्ड इट द साइक्लोन हिट द हाउस. What happened that when she was just reaching at the door, but the cyclone had hit the house. And then a very strange thing happened. The house rose slowly up, up, up into the sky. Aunt Em and Uncle Henry were down in the cellar under the ground. But the house, Dorothy and Toto went up to the top of the cyclone. Dorothy looked through the open cellar door and saw hills and houses a long way down. She closed the cellar door quickly. Look at here in this picture, you can see that this is the cellar door under the ground and this is the cellar door in the house. So Aunt Em and Uncle Henry was in the cellar room, but Dorothy and the dog was in the house because they can't reach the cellar room. And the cyclone hit the house. And when the cyclone hit the house, the cyclone blew the house with it. And the house rose high, high, high on the top of the cyclone. Dorothy just looking down towards her uncle and auntie and the trees and all the things. The wind blew the house along for many hours. At first, Dorothy was afraid. But we can't do anything about it, she said to Toto. So let's wait and see what happened. After 2 or 3 hours, she and Toto went to sleep. When Dorothy opened her eyes again, the house was back on the ground and everything was quiet. She picked up Toto and opened the door and went outside. They saw all trees, beautiful flowers and little houses with blue doors. So the cyclone was blowing the house for many hours. So after 2 or 3 hours, Dorothy was little afraid at that time. But after 2 or 3 hours, Dorothy said that we can't do anything. Just we have to wait and watch that what happened. So she and Toto went to sleep. But when she woke up, where was the house? They don't know where was the house because the house was on the land again. But they don't know where was it and where was they. When she opened the door, she saw tall trees, beautiful flowers and little houses with the blue doors. So at the first, at the starting of the story, Dorothy and her house was in Kansas. But at the end of the story, Dorothy don't know that where she was. She just saw tall trees, beautiful flowers and little houses with blue colors. Okay. So this is the story. Now moving towards the exercises. Put the sentences in the correct order. Okay. There are some sentences from the story. You have to put the sentences in the correct order like this. Uncle Henry saw a cyclone. So this is the first one. The house landed on the ground. Now which number will it come? The dog under hit the bed. Which number will come? The cyclone carried the house up into the sky. So you have to read the story and you will numbering these sentences according to the events that take place in the story. Okay. So you will do this in book. Okay. Read the story again and answer the questions. These are the questions answer. You will do it in the copy. The questions are, who did Dorothy live with? Where was the cellar? Where did Dorothy's aunt and uncle go? Where did Dorothy go? Was Dorothy alone? How long was Dorothy in the sky? Okay, this is your copy work. Complete the sentences with one word. Some words are from this story. You have to fill in the blanks. Okay, houses, schools and shops are of different kinds of buildings. A room under the house is called a what? Cellar. A very strong wind is called a what? Cyclone. Inside Dorothy's house, there were some pictures on the walls. Some birds were sitting on the roof of Dorothy's house. Dorothy's house flew up into the sky, then landed up on the ground again. Toto the dog was still hiding on the floor under the bed. Dorothy saw houses with blue doors. Okay, these are the blanks. So now lesson number 4, study corner. She has big brown eyes. She is wearing a blue cotton dress. We have to make sentences like this. For example, type A. There are some words, these are some words, and these are some words. We have to match these words to make a phrase or to make a sentence. Like, type A. A large hot bowl of soup. Okay, this is a phrase. A large hot bowl of soup. Okay, so then in this way you will do all the sentences. This is your copy work. Type B. A green woolen hat. Okay, so you can make these sentences according to you, according to your imagination, and according to your will. Okay, now write the simple past forms of these verbs. Okay, these are some verbs. You know that what are the verbs? Verbs are the action words, and these are the present forms of the verbs. Now you have to write the past forms of the verb. Like buy. What is the past form of buy? It is bought. Okay, so what is the past form of drink, wear, lose, and eat? This is the copy verb. So write sentences in the past simple, use the words in the right order. Now these are the sentences. You have to make it in the past form, and you will rearrange these sentences. Like, she bars of chocolate, tiny pie. Now we know that after subject there was verb and then the object. So she buy tiny bar of chocolate, but we have to make it past simple. So we will change the verb into the past form. So she bought tiny bar of chocolate. Okay, so the sentence will be, she bought tiny bar of chocolate. This is also your copy work, and you will do the rest of the sentences like this. She bought a tiny bar of chocolate. One has been done already for you. Okay, she cup of tea, hot large drink. She drank large hot cup of tea. What is the past form of drink? It is drank. Okay, so you will do the rest of the sentences by yourself. Now this 5, circle the correct word to complete the phrase. Write the phrase in your notebook. Okay, so there are two words. We have to circle the correct one. Like, a wonderful holiday or a helpful holiday. Holidays are wonderful, so a wonderful holiday. Okay, a powerful jacket or a colorful jacket. The jackets are colorful, not powerful. So this like that you will do the rest of the sentences, and this is also your copy work. So that is it. This is your unit, and it is done. We only do lesson 3 and lesson 4 in this unit. I'll meet you next time with another video. Till then,